afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Evansville, Indiana, the Ford Center for the 2022 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Championship. Now let's meet the teams. First, the Northwest Missouri State Bearcats. Hudgens launches. Yes. This guy is dominating right now. Exclamation point. Waters set for three. Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Dreamer. Yes. Good penetration, and Jackson finishes. And now the starting lineup for the Bearcats. A guard, 6 foot junior, St. Joseph, Missouri, Diego Bernard. At guard, 6 foot 2 inch, freshman, Independence, Missouri, Isaiah Jackson. At guard, a 6 foot junior from Manhattan, Kansas, Trevor Hudgens. A forward, 6 foot six, sophomore, Olathe, Kansas, Luke Waters. And at forward, 6 foot seven, sophomore, from Alvo, Nebraska, Wes Dreamer. And the head coach for the Bearcats, Ben McCollum. And now, let's meet the Augusta Jaguars. Crawford catch. Hammers it home. That's the seven-footer. Oh, that's a strong drive. Jacquez Kirby with the dunk. Kirby pulls a three.
Easy money.
Cracknell. That's another three. That's a strong move. And that's Tyree Myers. And now the starting lineup for the Jaguars. A guard, 6 foot one, a junior, Baltimore, Maryland, Tyree Myers. Yeah! At guard, 5 foot 10 junior, from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Miguel Arnold. At guard, 6 foot 4 inch, graduate student from Huntersville, North Carolina, Troy Cracknell. At center, 7 foot one, a junior from Griffin, Georgia, Tyshawn Crawford. And at forward, 6 foot six, a freshman from Hazelhurst, Georgia, Jacquez Kirby. And the head coach of the Jaguars, Dip Metris. Moments from Tip. Let's get down on the floor. AJ Ross. Hi, AJ.
Hi, Rich. Diego Bernard's impact is really felt on both ends of the floor for this Bearcats team. So when he took a hard, flagrant foul last time out versus Black Hills State and fell really hard on his left leg, there was a lot of concern. Yesterday, he was limited in practice, and today during warm-ups, he debuted a new knee brace on his left knee. Ben McCollum told me he is a tough kid, so if he's able to play, he is going to play. A four-time MIAA All-Defensive Team member. He currently leads this team in steals, and he is an integral part of this backcourt that is going to have their hands full today, Rich.
All right, AJ. Pete, he's so important, especially on the defensive end for them.
Tremendous defender. He locks people up. Very athletic. He's real explosive, Rich. It'll be interesting to see how well, but he drives the ball. We have that power attacking the basket with that bad knee.
Two very different styles here. Augusta's got the seven-footer. They like to get it inside. And the Bearcats offensively have such a smooth motion offense with ball screens and picks and all kinds of surprises. And here we go. This is Myers, terrific point guard. And the first touch for Miguel Arnold, great three-point shooter.
Northwest Missouri State plays man-to-man 95% of the time.
Dreamer having to battle the seven-footer in the low blocks. Kirby had a terrific semifinal. First touch, the big man likes to go with the left. Putback is up. Another shot, this one goes down.
He got hit about three times. Mitchell, once again, if the referees let him play, you're a good crew, right? Big advantage for Northwest Missouri State.
On offense, lots of ball screens, pick and pop bigs, and paint touch threes are important for them. They like to get into the three and kick it beyond the arc.
And you see, now the big fella is Gordon Jackson, who's not a great offensive player, so it'll be interesting. You give him shots and shoot all he wants.
Jackson probing. Dreamer shot blocks. That's Kirby.
He's a high-flying athlete, Kirby. It's interesting now. We have to see where Northwest Missouri State. I would set ball screens now. If they ignore you, Isaiah Jackson will set a ball screen now to help you. That's it. This guy is a brilliant coach, Ben McCollum.
Hudgens, who was held in check in the semifinals, we showed you the defense. He rarely touched the basketball.
Shot 2 for 7. Only had 11 points. He averages 23 a game.
Bernard, a good offensive player as well. The ball will stay with Northwest Missouri State. Get to know Augusta. Just 4 miles from where everybody at CBS is headed in a couple weeks. In Augusta National, in Augusta, Georgia. And Northwest Missouri, Diego Bernard puts him on the board. Not a lot of ball screens for this team. A lot of side-to-side motion with that seven-footer in the paint.
Yeah, 4 out, 1 in motion, inside out. They try to go inside. There's not many teams in Division II who can guard a 7'1" young man who's talented. Now about his progression, Rich. He got better and better each year.
Great feed and a foul at the end of the shot clock. And Crawford's going to the line. Wes Dreamer with the foul.
Great job. Great job by Diego Bernard. Yep, you got hit. They're going inside out, Rich, almost the whole game to the big fellow. Motion offense. As you said, they don't run the ball screens. You're worried about the big guy getting a moving screen or when he rolls to the basket, fouling somebody on the defensive end.
Crawford originally went to Georgia Southern and really didn't play much at all. He was overweight, out of shape, just got a few minutes. Dip Mitras remembers seeing him as a high schooler. And when he was looking for someplace else to play, he arrived at Augusta. He's dropped about 50 pounds. He's really changed his whole body and his whole game.
A great credit to the young man, Tyshawn, working so hard, and the staff. Dip Mitras and his staff did a wonderful job developing this big guy.
Hudgens kicks. This is Waters in the lane. Falling away. And not many rebounds go unclaimed when Crawford's in the game.
Yeah, Waters is a leading scorer for Northwest Missouri State with 17 the last game. He's going into the big fella.
Crawford backing in against Dreamer. Right hand, and he scores.
Right hand, left hand.
Early dominance right now. Let's go down to A.J. Ross. A.J.?
Well, Rich, something else that Coach Mitras emphasized with Crawford was that hook shot inside and free throw shooting. And when he first came to Augusta, he was only a 35% free throw shooter. Now he's at 70%, guys.
Yeah, just incredible transformation. Yeah. And that's Waters. That's a three. Northwest Missouri State can really shoot it from distance. 40%. Augusta is one of the best three-point shooting teams in the country. 43%.
Exactly, Rich. They're right at the top. Tremendous three-point shooting team. So it's going to be raining threes this afternoon here in Evansville. Be impatient. Work inside out every chance they get.
It's a defensive foul, and I believe it's on Diego Bernard.
Inside out, Dreamer kicks it out. Waters, that's easy money for him at three last game. Don't leave him alone. We'll make you pay.
I'm sure the Northwest Missouri State coaching staff, Ben McCollum and his group, spent a lot of time last night figuring out how they're going to guard, and Bernard may have picked up another foul. He did. Yeah. You saw the surprise and now the concern on McCollum's face. He's their best defender, and he's got two.
Here we see. Miguel Arnold now is going to cut to the basket. Boom. Good call. Two fouls on the best defender at Northwest Missouri State.
Mitch Mascari is into the ball game. He played well in the semifinals. High-low, and Dreamer with the foul. And right now, Northwest Missouri State is having trouble defensively.
It's a good call. Danny Basil, tremendous official. Yep, he's getting hit with the body. Can't do that. Danny Basil's from the Bronx, St. Raymond's High School. He's a ball player. Played for Gary DeCesa, who I know from New York City.
That is Dreamer's second personal as well. And Augusta goes right back to work. Crawford lost it.
Probably got hit again then, Rich. Need a game plan. Sometimes.
The game plan is get that guy the ball.
Exactly. Get him the ball. Good things happen.
Kirby has the rebound.
When somebody's dominating that Rich, okay, and I played against some great teams, might have to play some zone. I know that's not in the vocabulary, but Ben McCollum's a lot smarter than me. But you might have to consider some zone to protect the rim.
Cracknell. That's a three.
You said it before, Rich. A great three-point shooting team, Augusta. 43% from downtown.
Hudgens into the lane. Daniel Abreu has checked in for Dreamer. Mascari as well. It's not a deep rotation off the bench for either team. Hudgens. Mascari's a good three-point shooter. And Jackson stripped of it. One on the shot clock. Great start right now by the Augusta Jaguars, best three-point shooting team in the country. Good afternoon to everybody in Augusta, Georgia. The Jaguars off to a great start. 11-5 on top in this championship game, Division II men's basketball. We were talking about this guy, as A.J. Ross reported. He always had the jump hook, but, you know, not much more. And didn't have a lot of confidence, but Dick Metris and his staff have done a wonderful job.
Unbelievable job. And a lot of big guys don't have confidence. Rich, as a coach for a long time, we had a lot of big guys. They get shy, they look differently, right? They, you know, they don't fit into certain clothes, uniform. You got to get double XL and stuff like that. So building confidence is very important.
Dimitris, they are checking the shot clock. There should be 1 second left on that shot clock, I believe. When we went to break, it had 1 second on it.
Resetting the shot clock to 1 second.
So this is a catch and shoot situation.
Yep. Well, Coach Ben McCollum, he's got more plays than Shakespeare, so he'll do something good. He'll get a good shot off.
David Vitti has checked in for Augusta. If you just joined us, Northwest Missouri State has won three of the last four Division II championships.
You see a lob to the rim.
Mascari, a line drive three.
It's the score.
Just like they drew it up.
Yep. Heck of a play, even a better shot.
Arnold. He's a guy that can get hot in a minute. It stays with Augusta.
Scary. Cuts to the corner. Good defense. Better offense. It's a great three-point shooting team, Rich, as you mentioned before. You got a lot of answers, a lot of weapons.
Darren Lucas White off the bench. Cracknell. A little too much on that one. And which way is it going? It is staying with Augusta. 18th year for Dimitris. 13th season for Ben McCollum, who's only 26-5 in NCAA tournament games.
He's unbelievable. We watched practice the other day. He's brilliant. Rex Walters was here, a bunch of us, and unbelievable plays. Brilliant. Magician.
Crawford again. Crawford with two
Send
hands.
Home, big fella. Let the big dog eat.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
And right now, Northwest Missouri State has no answer for Tyshawn Crawford, who's got 8 points, four rebounds.
Not many teams have answers for that fella now. That's the only possible answer.
Can Hudgens get going? Abreu, and he's fouled.
He's left-handed, so he's going to go. He posts up on that right block most of the time, so he can take it to the middle. Throwing it home. Explosive. He got stronger and stronger. Rich, you said he lost a lot of weight. Wow.
You know, the other thing that was important in his development, his roommate is the point guard, Tyree Myers. So those two together are tight, both on the court and off the court.
I love Tyree Myers. He's my favorite guy in the team. He's their glue. When your point guard plays well, your team plays well. This team has won 19 games in a row. 19. Right? Northwest Missouri State has won 10. So something's got to give today, Rich.
And Abreu misses his free throws. Lucas White running the team right now. You got that three-point shooter, Miguel Arnold, in there as well. Right now, it's just feeding the post.
Yep. Inside.
There's the double. There's the left hand. Great job by Abreu.
Made him shoot over. They're playing behind. Last game, they tried to front him, and they just lobbed it over the top. So McCollum adjusted.
Hudgens. Now let's see if he can get rolling. 23 a game. National Player of the Year the last two seasons.
Tremendous player. He can play anywhere in the country.
Arnold. Lucas White. Cracknell. Again.
Cracknell's a tremendous three-point shooter, Rich. Look at this. Crowd's going bananas.
Six-point lead, Hudgens. Hudgens launches. No. Two of the top players for Northwest Missouri State picked up two fouls each. Diego Bernard and Wes Dreamer. And they've been on the bench since we are about 4 minutes into this game.
I think it's a great move by Coach Dimitris to have Jackson, who's the weakest offensive player for Northwest Missouri State. All right. He's the guy. He's gone Jackson.
Back to the line is Crawford. Get to know Northwest Missouri State. If you follow Division II basketball, you know all about the three national championships. Maryville, Missouri. Bobby is here. Gary Gaetti was a terrific major leaguer.
Yeah, Bobby the Bearcat's one of the top 10 mascots in Division II.
Now, is that a personal poll of yours, or is that the coach's poll, or
no,
is that the AP?
My personal poll.
Does Ken Palm have that?
Ken Palm's working on it. He's not yet into the mascots, but he's brilliant, Ken Palm. I love Ken Palm, but he's not mascot-oriented right now.
There's the difference in free throw shooting in his progression. And he knocks down 1-2. 7-point lead for Augusta. And the numbers next to those two schools, those are the seedings. They reseed the teams when they arrive in Evansville for the Elite Eight. Pay no attention to those seedings because these two teams evenly matched. And I think most people felt Northwest Missouri State was the favorite coming in.
I think so, Rich. They won three of the last four championships. So I think they're the favorite, but this is a great team here with Augusta.
Hudgens, and he threw it away. That's a turnover. This is essentially the same team that Ben McCollum has had the last few years, except for one guy who, in his fifth year of eligibility, decided, I want to give it a shot at Creighton. That's Ryan Hawkins. Hawkins was the second team All-Big East pick. He had a marvelous year for the Blue Jays in their NCAA tournament run.
Right now, Augusta's leading the battle of the boards 5-0. Big key to the game. Adolph Rupp, the great coach of Kentucky, won four national titles, said the team that controls the boards controls the game.
Well, with Crawford out, let's see if the Bearcats can make a run. And right away, Hudgens gets to the rim.
The personal foul.
If someone get in Evansville. As Pete would say, the big dog is eaten. Tyshawn Crawford in Augusta by 7. Welcome back to the NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Championship presented by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Quick start for Augusta, 17-10. Some of you may be asking, well, how good is Division II? Let's go back to an exhibition game back at the start of the 1920 season. And how about this, Pete Gillen? Northwest Missouri State gave Duke all they could ask for, and Trevor Hudgens had quite a night.
Unbelievable game. He had 27 points, leading scorer in the game, 7 for 13 from the three-point land, 4 assists, and Coach Krzyzewski goes up to Coach McCollum and says, hey, that guy's great. He could be a pro right away. He's that good. So the Bearcats almost beat Mighty Duke with all their All-Americans and their all-world freshmen. Hudgens was the best player on the floor, and he was a rising star.
Free throw is up and in, and he was on that team. That is Ryan Hawkins.
Yep. Tremendous player. I thought he'd be okay at Creighton, but he was tremendous.
He was outstanding. Second team all Big East pick. Averaged 14 and 8. Had 11 double-doubles.
Yep.
Different view for him. He's got 3 championship rings.
Yeah. Tremendous player. A lot of these guys are not Division II players. They can play any place in the country.
Kirby. Nice move, got it back, and draws contact. So this was his last 2 seasons at Northwest Missouri State and into Creighton. And, you know, once in Omaha, 14 points a game, he was outstanding. They made a run into the NCAA tournament without some key players. They had some awful injuries. Ryan Nemhard, their fine point guard, with about 3 weeks left of the regular season.
Yeah, they had some injuries that really hurt them, and they lost all 5 starters from the previous year. They went to the Sweet 16, Rich, as you know, and they lost all 5 starters. They still get back into the big dance and won the first round game over San Diego State in overtime.
Jaquez Kirby misses the second. Big man's back in. Tyshawn Crawford, 9.5 rebounds. Northwest Missouri State is shooting 50% right now. They're down 18-12.
Yep.
Hudgens. Yes. Wow. That was straight on, and that was deep.
He's unbelievable. What a player. What a player. National Player of the Year, 2 years in a row. Rich, as you mentioned, tremendous player. Got to go into the big dog.
Crawford against Abreu. Dreamer still on the bench with 2 fouls.
3 seconds. He's living in there.
Myers got to the rim.
Yeah. He's a tough young man from Pittsburgh. Big key to the team. Doesn't get the publicity that Miguel Arnold gets and Tyshawn Crawford gets, but Tyree Myers is a tremendous player. You have a good point guard, Rich, you have a chance to have an outstanding team. I think it's the most important position on the court is the point guard.
Hudgens right now is the offense.
Yeah, he's not a point guard, he's a point guard because he loves to score. 23 a game.
Another 3. And a foul, and I think Crawford grabbed him.
Personal foul, Augusta.
Nope. It was Myers on the rebound.
His first personal.
And his first personal.
Deep Mitras didn't like that one. Long shot, contestion by Crawford. Yep, good call.
Hudgens back to work. Abreu. No. Got the rebound. Keeps the possession. Mascari.
Yep. 10 threes a game for Northwest Missouri State. That's how much they score. Over 40% from three-point land. Most of their shots are from 3.
Hudgens, a runner.
Terrific defense by Augusta then, Rich. Keep going inside. Don't forget the big fella. Shoots 64% of the field. Go to him. Bed. Feed the post.
Offensive foul. His first.
Yep, I didn't like that.
His first personal. The team's 4.
Good call. Dip your shoulder a little bit. It's the block charge call is the toughest call in the game. Dip Meyer said, what's going on? Demetrius.
Dan Basil, Michael Svoboda, Dave Schadauer,
yep,
our three officials. Hudgens! Yeah.
He can take over the game. He's that good.
He's doing that right now.
Yeah, yeah.
He's got 10.
Yeah. Well, if we get 27 against Duke as a sophomore, no limit. He's got a high, high ceiling.
Arnold driving. Hudgens with the defense.
He's going up again. He's going to shoot it. He's hot.
Last 10 points for the Bearcats from this guy. Hudgens driving. Lost it. Kicks it. Mascari. Got it!
Coach McCollum's going crazy on the bench. Let's go. Fired up. He's counseling his players aggressively. Big guy, he's on that right block.
There's the catch. Gets it up, but not in. Strong rebound.
No foul. Goodness.
Held ball. Arrow goes Bearcats way.
You got a heck of a game here in Evansville. 1-point game. Hudgens steps back. Easy money for him. Unbelievable player. Way downtown. It's raining threes in Evansville. Stay with us on CBS. Coach McCollum fired up.
Quite a start to this one. 8 minutes left, first half, 1-point game, and the two stars are shining brightly right now. That's Trevor Hudgens and Tyshawn Crawford. Crawford, the 7-footer. Hudgens, the great 3-point shooter.
Big fella, two guys on him, no matter, we can. Throws it home, dominating the paint right now, Rich, but this guy, wow, no limit to him. Way downtown, that's easy money for him. Shoot 40% as a team. Right now they're shooting 50%. So the three-point shooting of Northwest Missouri State is amazing.
And early, Northwest Missouri State had trouble guarding Crawford. Lately, Augusta's had trouble catching Hudgens.
Yeah. Little zone here. Usually Augusta plays about 25% of the game on defense. Now, once again, Coach McCollum, I was watching practice yesterday with Rex Walters and himself, a bunch of people, and he carves up his zone like a porterhouse steak. Great action against his zone.
Hudgens, that's a launch. That was online, but short. And it bounces out of bounds, Augusta basketball.
Rich, I love when a team changes defenses. Usually, right? No stat on it right now, but usually when a team changes defense, the first possession, their opponent doesn't score. Dimitris, terrific coach. Played with Tommy Amaka in high school. The year behind him, great player at Duke. He's the head coach of Harvard now. Red Jenkins, a legendary coach in the Northern Virginia area. The dip was taught very well in high school. Beyond.
Arnold off the screen. In and out.
He can't buy it. Right now, semis, he's schooled. Right now in the final. They need him. Quarterfinals, as you know, he got 33 points, 7 for 10 from three.
Yeah, he's a great three-point shooter, 48%. Second in the nation.
Right. Weakness of the zone is that foul line area right there. Get him the ball with a skilled guy.
The strength of the zone is that 7-foot-1 guy in the middle.
That's protecting him from foul trouble. That's the main reason they're doing it.
And a nifty move by Byron Alexander, the freshman out of Kansas City.
Yep. Right now, Augusta's struggling on offense. Credit to defense by the Bearcats.
It's Abreu right now that is drawing the brunt of it. He's 6'6", 215.
Yep. You got to get a good angle to feed the post. Get below the foul line.
Myers feeds the post.
It's a contact. You got to call something. Yeah. He's getting beat up right now, Rich. He's getting beat up. That's why he's complaining.
A foul on the loose ball.
Look at Dip. Dip's going, what's going on? Watch. They're using their body as a weapon. He's bodying him. That's a foul. It's a body.
In the bonus, and that's going to send Troy Cracknell to the line. 80% free throw shooter. First one is good. Coca-Cola Zero Sugar. Best Coke ever, as in best of all time. Debate the goatness. Great three-point shooting team. Very good free throw shooting team, 74%.
Exactly. And Northwest Missouri State shoots 79%. So both teams shoot really well in the free throw line.
That's one thing you notice when you watch some Division II basketball. A lot of teams, their success isn't on smothering defense. It's guys who can shoot and are skilled.
Right. They're not super athletic in every position, but they can really shoot the ball, Rich. Exactly right.
Alexander probing. Mascari still in there. He's got two fouls. Hits another.
What a shoot. He comes off the bench. This team has a plethora of talent. That remains there, so they said to use some big words because you're really smart from UC Davis.
Well, at halftime, I'll show you the the dictionary app.
I need that. I got to try to work on my academic skills.
Myers, step back, on the way. Oh, that's a foul. As Mascari went under Cracknell. And that's his third personal.
The team saved. West Missouri State substitution. Number four, Isaiah Jackson.
Got underneath them. Mascari now with three. And of course, Wes Dreamer and Diego Bernard were on the bench with two fouls each, almost 4 minutes into the game.
Yeah, it hurts. Mascari's got 8 points, Rich.
There's your foul trouble. Yeah. But to Ben McCollum and the Bearcats' credit, they're on top.
They got tremendous talent. They have eight guys that can really play, defending national champs.
And they got Trevor Hudgens.
Yeah, forget about him. Awesome guard. Once again, he's a points guard, Rich. He's not a pure point guard. 23 a game. Might get 40 today. 1-3-1, he changed his zone. Dimitris changed his zone. 2-3 zone was decent. Slowed him down a little bit, but Hudgens going to shoot over.
And that zone certainly comes out to greet Hudgens. Abreu takes the three. Wow, way up to get the rebound is Alexander. Hudgens, shot fake.
Money, forget about him. Play him. Get a net. Ridiculous.
Mom and dad are here. And the Bearcats, with a lot of talent on the bench, are up four. Cracknell the miss. And the rebound to Isaiah Jackson. Trevor Hudgens has 13 points. He's hit four threes. And the zone disappears.
Yep, it changed.
Step back. Oh, that was short. Follow is good. Waters.
I'd call a timeout now if I'm Coach Dimitris. I know under four is one, but you got to stop the bleeding. Beat the big fella.
This is a 15-4 run and a strip. Waters got a hand on it. And this looks like a team that has won three of the last four titles. They lose so many players to foul trouble. And they don't blink an eye.
They don't blink. They got guys coming off the bench that are very good. It's a long game.
Cracknell maneuvering in traffic.
Get fouled. My goodness. Oh, my God.
It's a travel.
Look at Dip. He don't like it. I don't blame him.
Bearcats of Northwest Missouri State, a 15-4 run, fueled by the player of the year in the country, Trevor Hudgens. The LST 325 here in Evansville, home courts since 2005, Division II men's national championship game. And Augusta is here, and that's a clean-looking uniform, isn't it, AJ Ross?
It is ironically clean, and although things aren't going the way Augusta would want right now, if you're superstitious, you may say that their uniforms are a good luck charm. They have not lost in these tie-dye uniforms. If you look really closely on the left, you'll see there's one that has a faint blue undertone. Coach Meacher says he doesn't know who did it. There's a little something extra left in the laundry a few weeks ago, and Jaquez Kirby is the only one with a clean jersey because he didn't put his in the pile with everybody else. So we'll see if that undefeated streak with these tie-dye jerseys continues today, guys.
Yeah, he's still pretty clean right now. Everybody else has been wearing that most of the year. Hudgens. Bearcats on a big run right now. 15-4 run. Hudgens, shot fake, gets it off, and hits another!
Right now, Rich, it's his world. We're just passing through it.
Mike Krzyzewski was right in 2019. This guy can play anywhere.
Coach K's almost always right.
And nicely done. Jaquez Kirby, and that snaps the run. Kirby with a two-hand flush and a seven-point Bearcat lead. Hudgens backing in against Arnold.
They can see a double him, run somebody at him.
Little bump, little fall away. Goodness.
It's like he's playing in the park by himself.
18 for Hudgens.
Might get 40, Rich. You see why last game that Black Hill State wouldn't let me get the ball. And he gets it, he's the king.
Myers driving and he's fouled. And I think it's Hudgens. Coming up, AT&T at the half. Greg, Clark, and Seth will have a preview of the Elite Eight games. Trip to the Final Four, obviously, on the line tonight and tomorrow. It's coming up on AT&T at the half. This is the Division II championship game in Evansville. And Tyree Myers, the junior out of Baltimore, knocks one in.
That's why, as a coach, Rich, when you have a guy that's on an unbelievable roll, it's nice to have in your pocket a triangle in two or a box in one as a little bit of change of pace.
And Augusta has gone away from Crawford in the low blocks over the last 5-6 minutes.
Yeah, a little bit of amnesia. You got to get him the ball. And they're not feeding them from a good spot either. They're trying to feed from way out above the foul line. You got to feed the low post most of the time from below the foul line. Unless you got another big guy for the high-low, but they don't have another big guy that's throwing it in.
Hudgens, off a ball screen. Big man on him now. Another fall away. Another bucket! 20!
That's why you got to have a box in one. A trapezoid in one. Something. Don't let him touch the ball. That's what we saw last game. He only had 7 points. Give me 11 points. 2-for-7 from the field. He's in his zone now. Go below the foul line.
Crawford called for it. Into the lane. Offensive foul.
Yeah, Dick's going second. Crazy. You got to call it both ways. Body. He's bumping him with the body. He's moving.
Northwest Missouri State, 37-28, a 9-point lead. Northwest Missouri State on top. Dimitris, Augusta coach, not happy right now. Join up with Master Chief, humanity's only hope for salvation, in the new original series, Halo, streaming exclusively on Paramount Plus. Two key calls in the low blocks, both offensive fouls on Tyshawn Crawford.
He's got his arm on his back to start. Bumping him with his body, bumping him. Yep. Balance, rhythm, speed, momentum, they're disrupting that, in my opinion. But Gene's the expert.
Gene Steratore joins us now. I would assume, Gene, it's difficult when there's one guy that's 7'1" and another guy defending him at 6'5". How does the size differential play into this?
It definitely is, Rich. It's a great point. And listen, when you're that small, you've got to try to get as bodied up as you can, but you have to stay within the rules as well, right? So what Coach Mitras is, I think, upset about a little is first few possessions early in the game, they put whistles on what were kind of body bumps. Now we're seeing a player get the same body bump, trying to turn and make moves, and they're taking an offensive foul on him. This last feel to me, that feels more like a defensive block foul than it is anything on the offense. Not leaning into him, not driving through his defender. I see his understanding there, but this is difficult for these officials with such a discrepancy in size and strength in the low block.
Yeah, Gene, I hear you, but isn't freedom of movement, right? 10.1-4, you can't disrupt rhythm, balance, speed, right? And I think sometimes with the body, they're disrupting that. Maybe I'm wrong. You tell me.
No, Pete, you're right. But with that freedom of movement, if the defensive player is not standing in front of the player with the ball and giving him that space, if he's defending him from the side or from behind, he can go right up next to him without giving him that movement. But as soon as that big player faces up on the defender, he has to now give him that 2 feet of space for freedom of movement.
All right.
That's what's so challenging whenever they're posted up and on the side. Yes.
All right, thanks, Gene. Hutchins with a launch for three, and that is long. Wow, what a first half for that man. Trevor Hutchins, 6 foot junior out of Manhattan, Kansas. Northwest Missouri State was down early, and then Hutchins went off. 22 points, 8 of 15 from the field, and 4 threes. Let's check in with A.J. Ross.
Coach, you had two starters with two early fouls before the 16-minute mark, but Trevor Hutchins really stepped up with 22 points, as well as your bench. How well do you feel they've responded to those lineup changes?
Yeah, I mean, they did what they were supposed to do. You know, they got after O'Boards. I thought after the first, 5 to 10 minutes, you know, I thought we kind of settled in a little bit, settled down, got what we wanted offensively, and then we're able to get some extra possessions with O'Boards.
And then Daniel Abreu is this whole task of guarding Tyshawn Crawford. How do you feel he's done?
As good as you can. That guy's really good. He's really good. They do a great job of giving it to him. It's about as good a job as you can do on him. I mean, he's a tough matchup for anybody at our level.
Well, good luck, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you, AJ. What a run. A 29-11 run and a sizable halftime lead for the defending champs trying to three-peat Northwest Missouri State. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel and company in New York for AT&T at the half right after these messages.
This is AT&T at the half. AT&T 5G. Fast, reliable, and secure.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to AT&T at the half. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Clark Kellogg and Seth Davis. And the score in Evansville, Northwest Missouri State, by 39-28 over Augusta. I can tell we're in a good game because you walk in and you go, we got a good game.
Yeah. And we've got our partner back, Seth, in the house. Great to see you back.
Good
man.
To be here.
Coming up from
see
the south.
In person, in the flesh. Actually, yeah. Very impressive.
Very good. Well, I'll tell you what, Northwest Missouri State has been impressive, and it looks like they're on their way to a three-peat. But the big fella for Augusta, Tyshawn Crawford, is still a handful, and he got off to a pretty nice start. Here he gets it inside. He's 7 feet tall, and sometimes being that big is all you need. But persistence helps. Good job in there by the big fella going to work. Now he goes one-on-one, double team. Just uses that strong body to get right to the front of the rim. And one of the things that happens when you can do what he's just done there is that you force the defense to collapse a little bit, and now he's right on time on target with that pass. But the three-point shooting, always an equalizer against size.
And you know what that leads to. I don't know that in any level of basketball over the last many years we've seen a better combination of coach and player.
Woo.
Ben McCollum and Trevor Hutchins. And Augusta had to be feeling pretty good. About 6.5 minutes in, they thought he hasn't scored. Well, guess what? He went for 22 over the last 14 or so minutes, 4 for 10 from three-point range. He only averages about 23 a game on the season, so he's already there. His career high is 40. He's 23 years old. He's got that little jitterbug step with the lefty release. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Colin Gillespie at Villanova. They're not going to blow by you and go vertical, but so savvy at 23 years old, and it looks like he and Ben McCollum headed for yet another D2 championship.
But can he shoot, Seth?
A little.
47% career three-point shooter, and he's made over 400 of them.
All right, meanwhile, a D2 champion is about to be determined in Evansville. What's going to happen in the second half?
I'll tell you what, I think Augusta, the Jaguars, have to guard the arc. Seven three-pointers made by Northwest Missouri State. They've got to shut that down and get the big fella, Tyshawn Crawford, going again in the paint.
One thing's for sure, a champion will be crowned. Second half of Northwest Missouri State and Augusta coming up at...
NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Championship presented by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings, official sports bar of March Madness. GEICO. You could save even more by bundling home and car insurance. Rocket Mortgage. For the game plan on home loans, Rocket Cash. And by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Bossy Field in Evansville, built in 1915, third oldest ballpark in regular use behind Fenway and Wrigley. A league of their own filmed there. I'm sure Don Mattingly had a good time playing there as he was knocking balls out of the park. Reese's Peanut Butter Cups brings you our first half stats. And the three-point field goals jump out. The field goal shooting percentage jumps out. And Trevor Hudgens jumps out from that first half. Rich Waltz along with Pete Gillen. A.J. Ross will join us momentarily. Augusta had a seven-point lead midway through this first half, and then Trevor Hudgens with a couple key teammates on the bench in foul trouble put it in gear.
He got going. He was unbelievable. 22 points at the half, made 4 3-point shots. He just got on a roll. He was awesome. And we see now he's got the ball, all right? Once he gives it up, you got to stay pretty close and connected to him. He passes to his right. He moves. The defender now loses him. He tries to fly at him. Smart player. Shot fake. Shows a shot fake here. All right. One dribble to his right. Boom. Easy money for him. Bang. So, tremendous player. 4 3-point shots. He moves without the ball. He just felt that the basket was as big as the Atlantic Ocean, and he kept filling it. You need a lifeguard to play against Hembridge.
In the semifinals, Black Hills State denied him the basketball. He wasn't a factor, though they still won the basketball game.
Yep. They said, hey, let the other players beat me, and they did. Northwest Missouri, other players like Luke Waters beat him. So different ways to play, but, you know, he's certainly a great player, and he's on a roll.
All right, let's see what adjustments Ben McCollum makes, Demetrius makes. Diego Bernard and Wes Dreamer both in there with two fouls. For the into Crawford, kicks it out. And Arnold's jumper is in and out. Augusta has to get Miguel Arnold going. He averages 14 a game, and he's their best three-point shooter. He has not scored today.
He was great against Chico State in the quarterfinals.
Great pick and roll. No buckets, and the rebound to Crawford.
Yeah, he was 7 for 10 from three-point land in the quarterfinal, 33 points, but struggled on Thursday, and he's struggling tonight.
Fouls, and he's going to get a chance to get some points here. He's going to get three free throws, and we check in with A.J. Ross.
Well, Demetrius was fuming, and he did not mince words. He said they need to call a foul in Tyshawn Crawford's favor and not the other way. When I asked him about an answer for stopping Trevor Hudgens, he just shrugged, and he said the kid is good. So we'll see how Augusta adjusts in the second half here, likely switching between man and zone guys.
I'd add a superlative there, A.J., if I were him. He's not just good. He's really, really, really good. And he right now is beating Augusta with 22 points on 8 of 15 shooting. Arnold, out of San Juan, Puerto Rico, moved as a sophomore to Miami. His father, a basketball player. We asked him growing up, who was his favorite basketball player? Did he watch the NBA? He said, no, we didn't really have cable. I was a play-out-in-the-yard guy and really hadn't seen a whole lot of basketball on television until I got to Miami.
Tremendous player. He showed it in the quarterfinals. We mentioned he struggled Thursday, struggling this afternoon. Hopefully he'll get going. Reminds me of a Butch Lee, who played many, many years ago at Marquette for Al McGuire. Strong, powerful, excellent shooter.
Oh, there's a great name. Alexander. Baseline and a loose ball. Crawford has it, and Augusta has a turnover as they try to make their way back. Cracknell driving, dishing. Big man is fouled. And Tyshawn Crawford is going to go to the line.
Nice penetration. They come to help. Dreamer, who's guarding Crawford, helps. Yep. Fouled by Alexander.
Tyshawn Crawford. Out of Griffin, Georgia, co-player of the year in the Peach Belt Conference, where Augusta plays, as you would expect, being Augusta, Georgia. Has improved his free throw shooting. As we documented, his entire game has come a long ways, but he misses a couple. West Dreamer has the rebound.
When you're coming back, you got to make your free throws.
Switch off of Hudgens. Arnold had an arm wrapped around him. Knocked out of bounds, and it goes to the Bearcats.
Yep.
Ben McCollum is the best coach you've never heard of. That's what C.J. Moore in The Athletic called him. And a guy that a lot of Division I coaches have been calling and watching film and asking questions. And there should be a lot of Division I athletic directors calling, too. They have. He wants to move up to the Division I level, but he wants to make sure it's the right opportunity. And that's a nice give. Alexander with the finish, an 11-point lead.
Watching practice yesterday, Rich, he's unbelievable. He's like a scientist. He carves the team up like a porterhouse steak. Brilliant coach. Rex Walters, who played at Kansas, was there watching with me and other people, and shaking their head. And did a great job in his half-court execution.
His coaching profile, man, I mean, just the hardware he's got. Three national titles, won the last three of four national championships. Four-time D2 Coach of the Year. He was a guard at Northwest Missouri State. And, you know, success didn't come quickly for him. I mean, his first 2 years, they were 22 and 31. And then they started getting to the tournament. They had some Sweet 16 exits. That's a walk. And a turnover. The lead is 11. Hudgens hasn't scored in the second half. He has 22 and a sweet left hand. That's 24.
He's amazing the way he stops and goes. Like a halfback cutting through the lane.
Cracknell, and Northwest Missouri State first to the rebound. The all-time record in championship games in Division II is 40, held by Jimmy Daniels and Earl the Pearl Monroe. And this guy's got a shot at it. He's got 24.
Go to the zone because they can't stop the dribble penetration of Trevor Hudgens.
Good ball movement. Mascari is in. Hudgens attacking the top of the zone. Dribbling through. That one is blocked. Crawford got it. Maybe some up-tempo will do Augusta some good. That's a foul. And the big kid got hit right on the head. Tyshon Crawford is doubled over right now. There's the block on the other end of the floor.
Two free throws. Augusta.
Crawford was bent over holding his head. Let's see where he got popped. We got Myers at the line. He gets two.
His old teammate hit him, I couldn't tell.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, Kirby. Yeah. Gonna make your free throws, Augusta. One of the last four.
Yeah, 13 of 19 in the ball game. Some full court pressure. They're trying to stir this up.
A 1-2-1-1, trying to have their defense get their offense going. They're struggling.
West Dreamer is a big who can handle the ball. He plays outside, he can play inside.
Zone press back to a zone. That's the weakness, the foul line area. Great shooters all over the court. That's skill position.
How does this zone withstand the outside shooting, though, of Hudgens? Dreamer launches a three and missed it. Hustle rebound by Alexander.
Yeah, Northwest Missouri State's getting the offensive boards. Can't give them extra opportunities. Too many great shooters.
Mascari, Hudgens. Man on his hip. Corner three, Waters. That's beautiful offense.
Makes it look easy. Waters made three threes last game, 17 points.
Dreamer going to pick up the foul. That'll be his third. A blizzard of threes right now for Northwest Missouri State. And the Bearcats looking to three-peat in this national championship game.
And we are back.
We even got our lucky boots.
Okay, but Sarah's on the inside, Daryl's on the outside, always. Okay, come on, what are we doing? Let's focus. Okay.
We've got mango habanero, Asian zing, Parmesan garlic.
Eat them in that order, no exceptions. Not three times.
Oh, you guys are like really superstitious, huh?
Randy?
Yeah.
Beer in your left hand.
Left hand.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's always the left.
I'm sorry.
If we lose, it's on you.
Ready for the game. All right, game time, let's go.
Let's get this dub.
Can't say W, it's a jinx.
Randy.
It's amazing. He's talking about motorcycle insurance, and people love it. Of course, they love the savings they're going to get with Geico, but it goes beyond that.
You deserve to save.
Heard that before.
You deserve to save.
I know.
I need you to hear me. You deserve to save.
I deserve to save.
I mean, he has a way of making you feel seen.
Bundle car and motorcycle insurance and save at geico.com.
Oh, that spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Ooh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure, it's wireless.
Pick something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
It's Buick Envision.
Well, you should pick something stronger that's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot. Don't worry, I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
Buick Envision, an SUV built around you, all of you.
Don't miss Final Four Friday with a senior showcase unlike any other. It's the Reese's College All-Star Game on CBS Sports Network.
What do you got?
The full Hawaii experience.
I promise I won't let you get shot at again.
The NCIS crossover event, Monday on CBS.
Has stretched to a 31-11 run right now, and Trevor Hudgens has fueled it in a variety of places.
Scoring all three levels, Rich. Knocked down a three. We've seen a bunch of them. Mid-range game, get the rim and finish with either hand around the basket. Tremendous player. 24 points. He's 9 for 18 from the field, 4 for 10 from downtown.
We've talked about Ben McCollum and his creative offensive mind, but the first 60 minutes of every practice is defense. Northwest Missouri State.
Yep.
That's a three, and if he can heat up, Miguel Arnold can bring the Jaguars back.
Exactly. Well, tough shot. 2-3 zone. Here now by Augusta. Doing that because the penetration of Hudgens. All right, so they want to change of pace. They play 25% of the time zone, either 2-3 or 1-3-1. Now the weakness is the foul line area.
Daniel Abreu is in. West Dreamer out.
Now they go to a matchup. They try to match up with players when they can.
Abreu turning. Alexander's been really good on the boards, but he lost that rebound. This guy hit 7 threes in the quarterfinal overtime win that got him into the semis, and that's Miguel Arnold. And it's Hudgens who is guarding him right now. Myers launches. And the Bearcats with the lead and the ball.
Staying in the zone. Once again, they can't control the penetration of Hudgens. That's why they're in the zone. Trying to protect Crawford from foul trouble. It's the weakness of foul line area with a skilled guy. And all the Northwest Missouri State players are skilled.
Hudgens draws three men. Abreu is open for a three and got him. Abreu, the freshman, with a defensive play on the other end.
Yep.
Northwest Missouri State makes 10 threes a game. They got 9 already, Rich. There's a lot of time left, 14 minutes left.
Bray, you're feeling it. Hudgens, step back three. Yee-haw! Goodness! 27, mom loves it.
Unbelievable. He's going to make a lot of money next year if he decides to go pro. If he'll get to an NBA camp, whether he can make an NBA team as a six-footer, we'll see. But I think I certainly would look at him. I'm an NBA GM. Give him a chance. Bring him a summer league.
Some pro team in some country is going to want him. That's a strong flush by Tyshawn Crawford.
Yep. Back to man-to-man. Carving up the zone.
Hudgens starting, stopping.
So quick. Change direction, stop and start.
In the lane. Oh, that's blocked. Cracknell. Hudgens goes down. A little transition basketball here. Cracknell, three. Crawford. And he's fouled.
Driving to his right, behind the back, stopped through the legs. That's unbelievable. By far the best player in D2, and some great players in D2, Rich, but he can play any place in the country. Any school, he'd be very successful. Great, great player. Two-time National Player of the Year in D2.
Cracknell in the lane. And he misses a 10-footer. Augusta, one of the best shooting teams around, 43% from three, 49% from the field. And that's not happening right now.
Nope, credit to defense by Northwest Missouri State.
Hudgens. Why not? That one's long. And that's going to stay with Northwest Missouri State. One thing about this zone, though, you know, the Bearcats are happy running 25 seconds of offense and then getting a Hudgens three, which when you're trying to come back from this many points is not great.
No, no. He's taken 21 shots. The rest of the team, all right, has taken less than that, Rich. So taking more shots than the rest of the team. The rest of the team taking 18.
Foul. Defending champs, looking like it, Northwest Missouri State. Northwest Missouri State 52, Augusta 36. Division II championship game. In a couple of weeks, we head to the incomparable atmosphere of Augusta National for a tradition unlike any other. The Masters, April 9th and 10th. On CBS. Of course, the Augusta campus just 4.5 miles, which it seems if you strung all the threes together that Hudgens has hit this year, you might get that far.
No question about it. He's got 5 threes this afternoon. Shot fake. He'll shoot the three off a bounce. Step back. Makes people fall down. Tremendous player. 27 points. 5 assists. Awesome. Two-time National Player of the Year in D2.
Hudgens on the inbound. Under 12 minutes left. Hudgens. Good rotation.
He's surrounded by a lot of other good players. Rich, he can hit three.
Shot clock's down. Waters falling away. And now let's see if Augusta can get some sort of rhythm and make some run at the defending champs. That's a nice start. It's a two. And that's Lucas White, Darren Lucas White.
Gonna keep it in his hands unless somebody's wide open.
The personal foul.
Fourth team foul on Augusta. Darren Lucas White, his second. And this is Lucas White.
Lucas White's talking to him. Don't do that now. He'll make you fall down. Don't get Hudgens more upset.
That's a turnover.
Going to get fouled then. He got bumped. Yeah, McCallum said, hey, take it easy. Just calm down. Don't get in the spitting contest with your defensive player.
Guy's been here before, won three of the last four titles. You know, Bernard back in. Lucas White got by him.
Get fouled on the way in. Balance, rhythm, speed. He got knocked off balance.
And now Hudgens has got David Vitti on him defensively. And that one is off. He's cooled down a bit. Missed his last three threes. He's done a really nice job on the other end against Arnold defensively, has Hudgens.
Exactly, yeah. Complete player.
That's a line drive, two. And again, Darren Lucas White. And they're still hanging in there, as they should be, on the Augusta campus. 4.5 miles from Augusta National.
And getting some help from the other players, not just Crawford, but...
Another foul. And that's three on Lucas White. A win here, and it's a three-peat for Northwest Missouri State. Through basketball history, these are the notable three-peats. John Wooden, the Bulls, Phil Jackson and the Lakers, UConn, the women have done it a couple times.
Never been done, as you know, in Division II, three national titles in a row.
And remember, they didn't play this tournament in 2020. When Northwest Missouri State was number one in the country, and that's Waters with a strong drive. Just missed it. Crawford has the rebound. 12-point game.
Big possession now for both teams.
Into the post. Crawford kicks. Cracknell's three. That's as clean a look as you're going to get.
And he's a good three-point shooter also for Augusta.
See, the drought is approaching 5 minutes. Bearcats defense has been outstanding. Bernard corner, Mascari.
So what happens, Rich, that ball's in the hands of Hudgens so much, the other players have no feel for the ball. They haven't touched it.
Lucas White is fouled. And he's going to get free throws. Mitch Mascari, his fourth personal.
Transition before the defense gets set. Mascari with the foul.
Darren Lucas White adds punch off the bench. 10 points a game. Excellent ball handler as well.
Right now, 13 for 20 from the free throw line. 65% is not good enough when you're playing a championship game against a great team like Northwest Missouri State.
Northwest Missouri State has shot just four free throws. They are 2 of 4. Wow, missed from both. Cracknell has the rebound. Cracknell. Terrific second effort by Jacquez Kirby.
Tremendous athlete.
It's down to 10. 8-0 run.
Trying to keep the ball away from Hudgens now.
Bernard. Down he goes. And a foul, I believe. When a player's down with the ball, you can't necessarily dive on him, and that's where the foul is.
Here we go. Bernard driving.
It was not a trip.
Nope.
The whistle wasn't blown until right there.
Yep.
And Darren Lucas White, who's been a good boost off the bench, has got four fouls. And there's your foul trouble. Weighted heavily on Northwest Missouri State.
Well, Northwest Missouri State has seven fouls, so if you're Augusta, attack the basket, try to get to the free throw line and score. The clock stopped.
And they're trying to reset the shot clock. 20 seconds. And that's the difference in the offenses, certainly. Augusta, you know, pound in the post, attack the basket. Whereas Northwest Missouri State, especially against the zone, have been passing it, moving it side to side. That's Myers with the steal. And the buckets.
I'll call a timeout now, Bum. Coach Ben McCollum.
Single digits. The run is a 10-0 run.
Yep. A lot smarter than me. He's a great coach, but I know it's a timeout, a dead ball, but you don't want to be the richest guy in the graveyard. You're up eight. A little tired, a little drought.
Haven't heard from Hudgens in a while. He's got 27. Mascari, good shot fake. Three on the way. Wow, Kirby way up there to get that rebound.
What a great athlete. They're doing this now without their star, Crawford. Up for a cup of coffee.
Arnold. No, that was a long three-point shot.
Big shot. It would have really gotten them close. Take their time.
This scoring drought is almost at 6 minutes.
Yeah, gotta share the ball now. Keep moving around. Let other people touch it.
Foul. Waters scores and a free throw.
Waters, a terrific player. Hurts you from outside, inside. He's very, very good. Here we go. Need help for Hudgens. Waters, plenty of time. Pump fake. Chuck Daly would love it. Nice finish. He'll go to Bearcats.
This Thursday, TV's number one new comedy, Ghost, solves the mystery everyone's been dying to know. What happened to Trevor's pants? Why has he spent the afterlife pants-free? We find out when Ghost returns, much like Pete Gillen. Thursday, 9, 8 Central on CBS.
I'm back. I returned. We see now three-point shooting, 10 for 24 for Northwest Missouri State and 3 for 11 for Augusta. And points off turnovers, Rich, jumps up. 15 points off turnovers for the Bearcats, only 2 for Augusta.
Luke Waters trying to complete this three-point play. The storyline for the Bearcats, early foul trouble. Lots of Trevor Hudgens. He's got 27 points. And some role players off the bench have been terrific, especially the defense of Daniel Abreu against the 7-footer Tyshawn Crawford. This is Crawford in the high post. Myers runs into traffic. Crawford kicks, Cracknell's three, and he was fouled.
Well, big play. Cracknell's an excellent three-point shooter, but it's a coaching rule that don't foul a shooter, but never, ever foul a three-point shooter. Yep, he got him with the body.
Mascari with the foul. Just to clean that up, we were given Mascari's fourth foul about 2 minutes ago. They changed that during the break from Mascari to Hudgens. Hudgens has three, and that's Mascari's fourth. And that's a big free throw there. It gets it back into single digits. Also of note, Diego Bernard playing with that knee brace. AJ Ross had that report early on, that awful fall that he had in the semifinals. He has not played a lot. He was in foul trouble, but even here in the second half, he's on the bench right now. That's a big loss.
No question.
For the Bearcats. Wow, look at Kirby in there fighting for it, and he lost it. They'll have to settle for the two free throws, Will Augusta. There's your foul trouble. Dreamer, Hudgens, and Bernard, all key players.
1-2-1, one zone press here by Augusta, trying to get their defense, to help their offense get going. They're on a little bit of a run right now.
There's not much that the Bearcats have faced that they haven't faced before. They are really good operating.
Yep. Half court, the most efficient team in D2 in the country. Efficiency means how many points per possession, Mitch. So they do a great job each possession, right? They get over 1 point a game, so they're tremendously efficient. It's a great credit to Coach McCollum.
Kirby, great defense, blocks the three. And Augusta with a chance to cut into an 8-point lead.
Giant possession now for both teams.
Myers fouled on the drive by Alexander.
Here we go. Scary goes up. Kirby, a tremendous athlete.
He is.
He plays over the rim. Now you're going to make your free throws. Right now, Augusta is only 62% from the line, Rich. You can't win a game against a great team shooting 62% on free throws.
They've had plenty of opportunities. This is their 25th attempt. Oh, goodness.
No.
That one never had a chance. Myers, a 74% free throw shooter.
Well, pressure of a championship game, once again, can affect people.
You see the run. It was a 10-0 run, now a 12-2 run.
Yep. The ball's been in the hands of Hudgens so much, other players don't have a feel right now. I mean, he's Superman, but he needs some help.
On the drive, Alexander is fouled. That'll be the seventh team foul, and 1-1 for Byron Alexander. Tyree Myers, point guard for Augusta, his second personal.
Northwest shoots 79% from the free throw line, as we mentioned before, Rich. They make you pay on the line.
There's a great quote about Northwest Missouri State's offense. They will score more in the half court than teams that play fast. And that's the efficiency that you talk about. And they play at the slowest pace in the nation. At the very bottom of pace and at the very top of efficiency. And they average 77 a game.
It's amazing. Well, it's unbelievable efficiency. And they do the little things. Watching a coach play.
Another three by Arnold. That was a tough shot. Load up again. This is Myers. Yes, he got it, and that's a big shot. And look at this. Augusta has climbed within six. 5 minutes left in this championship game here in Evansville.
I think it's Hudgens' time. He's going to take over soon.
Alexander. This is Hudgens.
He's going to score now, Rich. He knows it's
40 down
times.
On the baseline for him. Crossing over, behind the back, stumbles, got it back, launches. And a shot clock violation and a great defensive sequence for Augusta.
Yep. Credit Tyree Myers with great defense and that possession.
Four and a half left. 6-point game. Into Crawford against Dreamer. Double team comes and he's fouled. And they need the big guy to hit some free throws.
Byron Alexander, his fourth person of the team's 10. Two free throws. Augusta, Northwest Missouri State, common foul, remainder of the game.
Alexander with his fourth personal.
Tyshawn Crawford.
Crawford, 3 of 6 from the line. 70% this year, though. And remember our story, AJ told it well, about the improvement as a free throw shooter. 35% when he stepped on campus.
Ooh. I've had a few guys like that, Rich. That's why I'm on Boot Hill as a coach.
Did they improve like this guy?
No, I didn't counsel them as aggressively as I should have.
4-point game. He hits them both.
National Player of the Year two times in a row now. He's got to step up. Doesn't have to shoot it, but he's got to create a shot for himself or his teammates, and I think he will.
Hudgens Alexander in the paint. Dreamer finds Hudgens. It's a three. And it's long. Kirby, another sky rebound. My goodness. And he's fouled. Free throws when we get back. The Jaguars of Augusta are back and down by four. A 17-3 run has improved the mood on the Augusta campus.
Yep, fired up. Mascot's fired up. He took a nap before Augustus, but he's back.
Tomorrow on CBS, NCAA Men's Basketball Championship Regional Final, 2 Eastern, top-seeded Kansas against Miami, North Carolina, and everybody's favorite, St. Peter's. That Cinderella story continues. Elite Eight tomorrow on CBS. What a run it's been for Augusta.
Yep. 17-3. Excellent defense. Myers with the steal. Finish in transition. Here we go again. Myers again. Pittsburgh downtown. Gutty little point guard.
And remember that long drought of almost a little over 6 minutes for the Bearcats. 1 of 10. In the last 10, and another miss on the free throw line. Jacquez Kirby is a 73% shooter.
Yep. Well, pressure makes things happen, Rich. Again.
He missed both of them.
Yep.
Hudgens hasn't scored in 10 minutes.
Yep. Augusta only 58% from the free throw line. 17 for 29. Lose a close game. That happens. This could be a big reason.
Cracknell defending. Screen comes. Hudgens spins away. Shot clock down at 5. Dreamer. Hudgens. A peek at the clock. Falling away. Yes! Big shot! Trevor Hudgens.
Great
6-point game.
Yep, gives you a great play. Make great shots. And money time.
Into Crawford, backing in, left hand, and he answers. Back to a 4-point lead. 3 minutes left, championship game, men's division two.
I consider running at him now when it gets to about 12 seconds on the shot clock. Get the ball out of the hand of Hudgens. If you're Augusta, he's gonna make it.
Pick, roll, Alexander in deep, and in too deep. Shot altered by Crawford, who has the rebound. Crawford, 15 points, 11 boards. This is Arnold. That's a three, and a huge one. A 1-point game. Augusta on the doorstep.
I call a timeout now. I'm Coach McCollum. He's a lot smarter than me. Got to stop the bleeding. Good. Dip's going crazy. If you look at the video,
he thought that, now let's take a look. From our angle, it was hard to see. This is the three that rattles home for Miguel Arnold. Here's the foul that has put Hudgens at the line. I don't know.
He's saying flop. That's what Demetrius is saying. It's a flop.
As you would expect, Hudgens is a great free throw shooter, 90%. 2-point game. Hudgens hot in the first half and early in the second. Now has 30 points. And he's money on both. Bernard is back in. Great defender, slowed by the knee injury. Crawford. Turned away.
Yep. He has trouble going off that other shoulder. He's a lefty. Tries to go off that right shoulder. He's got to be able to go both ways. Dick didn't like that, but I think the referees did a good job in that possession. Column.
Hudgens skips it. Waters. Bernard. Back to Waters.
Great interior passing by the Bearcats.
Timeout Augusta. 5-point lead for the defending champs. 61-56. This time it wasn't Hudgens. Bernard to Waters. NCAA two championship game. Then McCollum on the left to the Bearcats. Dimitris on the right for Augusta.
I go inside to the big guy. He's on the right block where he should be because he's left-handed. He likes to come to the middle.
They get it into the big guy right away. Crawford hits, and that's a three by Arnolds that's way off. Yeah. And the rebounds out of bounds. Northwest Missouri State ball.
Arnold's only 2 for 6 from three-point land, so didn't have his three right now. Keep the ball in your superstar's hands, which he'll do.
An 18-point Northwest Missouri State lead was melted down to 1. But the Bearcats have stretched it to 5.
Don't foul him now. He's a 90% free throw shooter. Make him beat you from the outside. Get the hand up.
Driving in traffic. Kicking. Waters. No. Tipped. Mascari with the rebound. And he draws contact.
Got a box out. Nobody screens out. Dreamy gets a part of it. Kirby can't control it. In and out. Great camera work. Great hustle by Mascari.
Yeah, Mascari, 81% from the line.
Northwest Missouri's had 9 offensive boards, Rich. Big part of their success. Not shooting a great second half, but they're getting second and third shots.
Officials are checking to see who the foul is on. Dimitris. Boy, as nervous as he might be, you think about his mom, whose birthday is today, Josie Mitris, along with his dad, Patrick, are in the D.C. area watching on television.
Yep. Did a great job.
And I'm sure for Ben McCollum, his whole family is here. I mean, and his coaching buddies are watching as well. Jeff Linder and Grant McCasland, Wyoming and North Texas. That trio, very, very tight. Well, if it's Kirby, yep. That was the initial call. Yep. If it's Kirby, it's his third.
Yep. That was the right call.
And Mascari drops in a free throw. There's the family of Ben McCollum. Looking for his fourth national championship in the last 5 years. One free throw goes down.
Two possession game now.
Arnold's quick three. Yeah. And Mascari has the rebound.
Not a great shot. Not a great shot. Yet time. You know, almost 50 seconds. Part of the problem the last two games, Rich, is Arnold's taking bad shots. He's off balance. He'll be a little more patient. Shot selection, a bad shot is like a turnover.
Crawford picks up his third. Part of the story here, yeah, look, Hudgens has been awesome, right? 31 points. But the bench, the guys that have come off the bench for Northwest Missouri State, Mascari has been outstanding. He's got 10. Abreu played great defense on Crawford when Dreamer was in foul trouble. Yep. And Byron Alexander's been outstanding as well.
Yep. Great point, Rich. A lot of talent. A lot of these guys can play Division I.
Myers a three. That's knocked out of bounds. And that is a Northwest Missouri State. Dimitris doesn't like it. They can watch, obviously. We're well under 2 minutes. Let's see what we see on our first look.
That looks like off Dreamer right there initially, Rich.
See. Yes.
I don't think it hit anybody after. I don't think it hit Crawford. A great camera crew. Look at Dip. He's going bananas. They're both outstanding coaches, Rich. Both had tremendous years. Unbelievable. Augusta had won 19 in a row coming into the game, and Northwest Missouri State 10 wins in a row coming into the championship game.
Gene Steratore, how are you? What'd you see? We see Wes Dreamer knocking it out off Bearcat.
I agree with you guys as well. And then you should get a quick reset on the clock. I think they just did do an adjustment to 38.9 on the game clock as well. So you've got to get that pieced in as well. I think they did a good job.
Yep, they did a great job. They looked at it and made the right decision.
Thank you, Gene. 8-point lead. Cracknell, good defense. There's the three. No foul. Kirby, the tip won't go. And Bernard has it. 30 seconds left. 8-point lead. And the three-peat
Augusta, number two, Tyree Myers.
Is 29.9 seconds away.
Two free throws.
First in Division II history is what it would be. Four of the last five. Remember, there was no tournament in 2020. They were ranked number one in the country, though, when the season was ended. And Bernard's, who banged his knee in that scary fall in semifinals, started the game. He and Hudgens have been together. Together, they are 16-0. In NCAA tournament games, 16-0 in their careers.
Two great guards. We didn't see the real Bernard. He showed a lot of guts playing.
Cracknell, three, that's short. Rebound, stolen away. Myers, left hand. And with a quick score, 15 seconds left, but still an 8-point lead. Dreamer's fouled, 12 seconds left.
The
McCollum, a fabulous coach, class guy.
Is this the last game he coaches at Northwest Missouri State? He has said that, yes, he does have Division I aspirations, but it has to be the right opportunity and the right job.
Yep. Well,
and that man, we asked him, is this your last game here? And he said yes. He wants to play professional basketball. And so he has an opportunity to come back for a COVID year, but it sounds like he's headed to play pro ball somewhere.
Yeah, no question about it. I think an NBA team will bring him to the summer league. He's only 6 foot, but I think he can play in the NBA. He's tremendous and can't do any more, Rich. Two times National Player of the Year in a row. Three out of the last four championships.
Kirby the miss. He's out. Ball out of bounds. Northwest Missouri State with 6 seconds left. The celebrating starts. You can loosen the tie and enjoy the ride. Four of the last five, three in a row. A dynasty of Division II is Northwest Missouri State. The Bearcats are national champs. Again and again and again.
Tremendous team. Hudgens a fabulous player, great help off the bench, great coaching. They're in a league of their own, Northwest Missouri State, the Bearcats. They do it defense, Rich, offense, three-point shooting. Do everything. They take care of the basketball. They don't turn it over much. 10 turnovers a game. Every part of the game you can check off the box, the Bearcats do.
Hudgens finishes with 31. He hit five threes.
This team could beat a lot of Division I teams at all levels. We talked about it before early in the game. We played Duke exhibition back in 2019-20 season. Lost 69-63 to Duke, who was ranked fourth preseason that year.
Two-time player of the year in all of Division II. And certainly the player of this Elite Eight, the Final Four, and the championship game. Trevor Hudgens and the Bearcats with the trophy.
Yep.
On a championship Saturday in Evansville.
Yep. Hudgens took 24 of the team's 50 shots. That's good coaching. Give the superstar the ball and get out of his way. Look at him. He deserves it.
AJ Ross is down there somewhere in this blizzard with Ben McCollum. AJ?
It's beautiful. History made, a dynasty born. Team ever to win three straight Division II titles. How special is this moment?
It's pretty special. Usually with these moments, you get excited, but you're always kind of on to the next. This is unbelievable what those guards have accomplished, and the whole team just having lost a really good player and then being able to come back and be able to win it, just says a lot about the kids in our program.
You mentioned the guards. You've had the best offensive efficiency rating across all D2, top five in defense as well, because of Trevor Hudgens and Diego Bernard. How dynamic are they?
Oh, they're unbelievable. They'll never be another duo like them in Division II basketball. They're unbelievable, unbelievable human beings. They just willed us to victory.
And when you think about all or reflect on all the challenges, not just in this game, but this entire season, that this team has persevered through and adopted that toughness, that grittiness that you discussed, what stands out most?
I mean, just that. The kids, we're relentless. We just kind of keep coming at you. No matter what goes, if it goes against us or for us, we just keep coming at you. I've just been blessed with really good kids. It makes me look like I can coach a little bit.
Well, you're a great coach at that. And people have come near and far from this Northwest Missouri community to witness history today. What has it meant to you and your players to have so many supporters in the stands today?
Yeah, that's what we do. I mean, that's what we do, is that kind of crowd. Got a big crowd over there. That's who we are. We travel. We're a family. It's phenomenal.
All right. Well, I'm going to move on to the young man behind you, Trevor Hudgens. Trevor, you certainly put on a show today. Whenever your team needed a big shot, that's what you stepped up and did. But you're no stranger to winning either. And now this is history. You and your teammates are etching your name in history. How special is this for you?
I'm speechless. I don't even know what to say. Glory to God first. I pray for things like this. It's just a blessing to be in this environment, be in this title game with my team. These guys are fighters. I don't even know what to say. These guys are fighters. From day one, we fight. From day one. And to the end.
And your talent has been on display over and over again. You had 31 points today, 5 assists. But you also had options over the last 4 years here at Northwestern Missouri to go to other schools, to move up to D1. Why did you stay? Why did you want to continue working with Ben McCollum?
I mean, Coach Mack, he's been a stand-up dude since day one, since I met him. He's believed in me when no one else did. He's developed my game to what I am today, honestly. Starting from my redshirt year to my fifth year now, it's all credit to him and the system here at Northwest. Then again, I got my brothers here, We work so hard. I work so hard, man. Speechless. I don't even know what to say.
You're leaving a powerful legacy behind. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
All right, that's incredible stuff. Nicely done today and throughout the week, AJ. To continue watching the postgame presentation, you can go to cbssports.com. Evansville, Indiana, site of the NCAA Men's Division II National Championship. And once again, Northwest Missouri State, the Bearcats. 3 in a row, they are a dynasty at D2. Tonight on CBS starts with FBI, then back-to-back editions of 48 Hours. For Pete Gillen, AJ Ross, Gene Steratore, our entire CBS crew, I'm Rich Waltz. So long from Evansville.